Last time, I showed you a simple way to remember how to unwrap a cube. Today though, I'm going to show you a memorable analogy for the cylinder this time, which is our second fundamental object to know how to unwrap, to pretty much unwrap anything. For this one, I like to think of Harry Potter glasses. So you can imagine a circle with a line between it and then another circle. And you can imagine that Voldemort's taken those glasses and snap them to kind of create that 3D shape of a cylinder. So let's put this into practice. First, I'm going to left click my cylinder. I'm going to press Control A. The reason I'm doing this is because I need to apply the scale first, just in case I've made any edits in object mode. And this will make sure that we have the right proportions once we UV unwrap. So I'll choose scale by left clicking it, and then I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode so we can start unwrapping. I'll press 2 on the keyboard to go into edge select mode, and we're going to select the first part of our Harry Potter glasses, which is going to be this top face. So I'll alt left click this edge loop here to select it. Then I'm going to shift select one edge down the middle, and this is going to be the kind of bit that holds the two lenses together. Then I'm going to go down to the bottom here, press shift alt, and then left click this edge loop here to select our other lens. And the whole snapping thing I made was pretty much me just explaining how, rather than straight glasses, the two lenses have been snapped down by 90 degrees. Then I can just right click and then choose mark seam. Then all that's left to do is press A to select everything, U to open the unwrap menu, and press unwrap. And now you can see we've got our cylinder unwrapped here. And all we need to do is open this unwrap menu here and select a margin, since we have more than one island here. An island is just one of these individual sets of one or more faces. I'm going to set the margin to 0.01 and press enter. And now we've got a nice little bit of space between each island, which is essential to avoid any issues. And yeah, that's about it. I thought I'd share that quickly just to show you another memorable analogy for unwrapping cylinders. This one's definitely the easier one of the two when compared to cubes, but still useful to know nonetheless. If you want to learn more about UV unwrapping, such as handy tips to speed up your workflow and some of the most fundamental knowledge for UV unwrapping, make sure to check out my UV unwrapping playlist for beginners. I've also got a video on UV unwrapping complex objects, which is great if you want to put into practice UV unwrapping cubes and cylinders using a complex object as an example. Next time, we're going to be learning how to UV unwrap multiple objects at once into one UV map, which will be handy if you want to use one texture for multiple objects in a video game, for example. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.